Hey, horsey people! I'm gonna cover bitless bridles and hackamores and mechanical hackamores and all kind of other things for the horse's face. Now, I'm gonna go through quite a few pictures and it'll be a little bit redundant, but I wanna make sure everybody understands if you watch this video because I get a lot of questions about this and that and S hackamore and this hackamore and this. So, I'm gonna try and turn things as I see it. And then you could take it for what it's worth. So let's take a look at some of these here just on a screen now. This is a regular traditional hackamore. It consists of a bozelle with a hanger and reins. No leverage. This is your traditional hackamore. This is called a mechanical hackamore. It's mechanical because it has chains and levers and tension. And this gets pulled down on a horse's nose when this gets pulled back. And when you pull back, this pulls up and the chain tightens underneath the horse. Those are called mechanical hackamores. I don't like that they're called hackamores because people go, oh, I ride with a hackamore, so I don't use a bit. This is a external squeeze pain metal bit. This is an external squeeze pain. This doesn't have metal. This doesn't have metal. This has metal. So I'm going to go through and kind of explain some things, difference between leather, rope, etc., and see if we can clear some of the questions up. So this is considered a bitless. I think this might be Dr. Cook's. Let me see if it's I think this is Dr. Cook's what he calls a bitless bridle. And I mean, this is better than metal and leverage by all means. You get rid of metal chains. If your system doesn't have any metal or any chains, you're on the right path. So this has a crossover method, and I've talked about this before. When I pull on this rein, it crosses under the horse's chin. When I pull on that rein, it crosses under this chin and pulls. So you're getting a constricting type maneuver when you pull. I don't like that. That's why I like the traditional hackamore or the rope halter. And I know the idiots will tell you that rope does just as much damage as metal, but they're just fools. So this is okay and is better as long as you're getting away with metal. I just don't like things that cross under and cause constriction and pressure versus just pulling right here at the bottom of the chin, and it gets the horse to dip his head and it gives him clear direction on which way to move his head. I say this all the time. If your horse can lead in a halter, he can ride in a halter. If you can control your horse, lunge your horse, tie your horse, move your horse left, right, and backwards and forwards when he's on a lead rope with a halter, then it understands it if you get on his back and you do the same thing. So it's less confusing. You don't have to change bits all the time. I like using a rope halter. This one is leather, so I know the English like it because it's more leather. They don't like the Western look of the rope, but it still crosses under. You see these two straps. They twist and go underneath the horse's chin. So when I pull on this, this tightens and this tightens. And then it constricts. And it doesn't get what I call immediate release. When you let loose of this pressure, this tightening will release as the horse moves and as the halter moves, but it's not immediate. And horses learn on immediate release. So this is the one we looked at earlier. Again, when you get metal and chains, it's always bad. So they took the metal out of the horse's mouth and they put it on the outside. Underneath this plastic is metal. And this is a chain. So when you pull on the bit here, it goes back this way. It causes this to go forward, which pulls this down and tightens behind the ears. It pulls this forward, which forces this down on the horse's nose. And it pulls this up, which forces up on the chain underneath the horse's chin. And people go, oh, I ride bitless. I ride a S hackamore. Oh, this is a hackamore. Hackamores are nice. This is a mechanical hackamore because it uses mechanics. This is a traditional hackamore. It does not use mechanics. It has the pull at the bottom. The two ropes hang. This hangs loosely. When I pull on this rein, it simply tilts this back. This is a leather, flexible piece of leather. So when I pull, it bends. It's not digging into the horse's hole unless I put concrete on it or make this solid wood. It's not dent. It's soft bendable rawhide or leather. They make them out of rope, etc. But it's one loop, and when you pull on a traditional hackamore, this is a traditional hackamore, not a mechanical S and all that other stuff. There's no metal. This metal right here is for decoration. That shouldn't even be there. The traditional hackamore is the leather ties, and there's no metal anywhere. So when you pull on the rope, it gives the horse guidance and clues to when I pull on this side, he feels a little pressure on the top here. He feels the hackamore tilt back. It causes him to tilt his head, and it's not force, pain, or leverage. I can't yank. When I pull on this rope, I get 1 pound of pressure per 1 pound of pull. When I pull on this rope, I multiply. If I pull on 1 pound of pressure, I multiply the poundage through leverage because this is long and curved, and it causes torque here by pulling the leather, and it causes torque there by pulling up on the chain, and it causes torque there by pushing that down. So it's very simple to tell the difference between traditional hackamores and mechanical. I don't know what the hell this is. This poor horse, his nose is straight up. He's got a bit in his mouth, metal. There's so much crap here. People are like, oh, I use bitless. Oh, I just tie the horse's mouth down to keep the bit secure. All these excuses for metal and pain. Anybody that looks at this and doesn't see cruelty, well, you're an idiot. I can't help you. I can't fix stupid. Traditional hackamore. It's got a soft piece of leather hanging. It's got the hanger that holds the leather, and it's got the ropes underneath. This third rope here is what's called a tie down, and that's a traditional hackamore or Makati reins that when I get off, I can lead the horse with this rein right here. Otherwise, it's just tied to the horn, and my two reins are made for riding. This little piece of leather here that's flapping is called a shoe fly. Sometimes they'll put a little horse hair, and it just keeps it moving as the horse moves. It shoes flies away. Again, this is a traditional hackamore. Notice there's no metal anywhere. The reins come back. It's just a piece of rawhide around the nose. It's loose. When I pull on the reins, it makes it slide forward. So somebody with heavy hands will say, I don't like riding with a hackamore because it makes my horse bald here. If your horse is getting rub burns here, your hands are too heavy. You're pulling on the reins too much. You're riding with the reins. I mean, you can call it what you want and say, oh, my horse doesn't like it, or oh, my horse doesn't stop with it, or it rubs my horse raw. All of those excuses goes to the person pulling on the reins too much. They don't know how to ride. They don't know how to give a clue. They're too hard. They think they have soft hands. They tell people they have soft hands. They really have hard hands because soft hands make soft horses. And if you have soft hands, you're not going to have a bald spot here, and you're not going to worry about ruining that. Okay, so again, mechanical hackamore. It's got a rope across the top, long metal shanks, chain in the back. So just because you're not putting anything in a horse's mouth, you're still creating an awful lot of pain because this rope squeezes down. And that's what a lot of people tell you. Oh, I don't like hackamore because it's squeezed on the top of the nose. A regular hackamore, traditional hackamore, does not do that. A mechanical hackamore does do that. Another mechanical. They put leather on the top, but then they have chain on the bottom. So when you pull on this lever, it torques the headstall, connects to here. So it torques the headstall tighter. This is cushioned on the top so it looks nice, but the chain underneath is digging and being pulled up into the horse's bottom of his chin there. Another mechanical hackamore. Nice, curvy, smooth, S-looking things. Chains, hard rope across the nose. This squeezes the nose. The chain squeezes up when you pull on the leverage. Another mechanical hackamore. This is your traditional mechanical. Piece of leather on the top and a chain on the bottom and nice long shanks. So it multiplies you. You pull 1 pound of pressure and this long shank that hangs low torques and increases your torque to where the horse gets squeezed with like 20 pounds of pressure. Mechanical hackamores are not good. They're better than a bit, but you can still hurt a horse if you got hard hands. Mechanical hackamore, same thing. Fancy rings, big rings, little rings. It's still all torquing. Traditional bozelle. A bozelle is the leather soft piece that goes around. When I tie a hanger on here and I put reins on here, it becomes a traditional hackamore. Some people will call this a hackamore. It's not really a hackamore. It's part of the hackamore system. This is a hackamore system. It's got the hanger, the leather bozelle, the reins. This little thing here is another piece of thing that keeps the bozelle from hanging forward, and it's called a fiador. And I have a video on that on tying one of those. This is a traditional hackamore. It's got the leather piece that hangs over the nose. The reins are connected. This piece of rope here is called the lead rope that I showed you on the other horse. And it's got what's called the hanger for the bozelle. Traditional hackamore. This is some bitless system. I don't know if the rings are hooked here or if they strap underneath. I see a lot of straps on top. This looks like a pretty decent system. Why? Because I don't see metal. I got a metal buckle here I don't like. I got a metal buckle here I don't like. Maybe there's a little metal connector here. Not the end of the world, but I like no metal. If you're using metal, you probably got issues because you're pulling so hard that you don't even realize it. And the metal compensates and hurts the horse, so the horse listens and it may look soft when it actually is not soft. This is another type. It looks like a rope halter that they've made flat. They've got nice little rings here that you can hook your nice little metal buckle to. I don't like these because, not that they're bad for the horse, I don't think you control and get as good direction of the horse. When the reins are on the side of the horse, like bits, you have to pull the head sideways, and that's why people use tie downs, because they want the head to drop. When you pull at the bottom, like on a hackamore, when you pull this side, it pulls the horse to the side and it gives him pressure downward. So the horse tends to naturally throw his head down. On these, a horse will throw his head up because you're pulling to the side, and then people will want to put a tie down down because they say, my horse pulls his head up and he can't ride bitless, so I need a bit. When you pull on a bit, the horse doesn't want to pull his head up because it hurts. On a bitless, he may pull his head up more because you're pulling on the side. Which is why I like when the reins are at the bottom of the chin, like on a rope halter and a traditional hackamore. Okay, let me readjust this. So on this one, we have it strapped underneath, so you're still getting squeezing pressure. It's rope on top. There's a, I looked like a metal piece right there, so I don't like metal. When you pull and this squeezes, it's going to put pressure. It's going to put pressure on the nose. You're using squeezing action versus when it's under the chin, you're directing the head low and to the side you want. This, before you even move the horse, he gets a squeeze around his whole nose because this is tightening and the bottom is tightening. That's why I'm not a fan on a lot of these fancy bitless bridles that people want to do. This horse has metal hooks, metal things. It's on the side. Again, I would prefer it underneath. I think it gives better thing. At least there's no squeezing action here. This doesn't tighten and this doesn't tighten when you pull on this. It just gives a pressure point here versus the pressure at the bottom of the chin on a traditional rope halter or hackamore. This is a mechanical crazy bit. Again, the halter is connected to this metal piece. This is connected to this metal piece. This is connected here. A lot of people will put chain here. Leather is better because leather stretches. But then you have this long shank. Shanks create leverage and increase your pull. You pull 1 pound, this long shank makes it feel like you're pulling with 5, 10, 15, 20 pounds. So when the rider pulls here, this goes down, which causes this to tighten up on the nose. When they pull here, this goes forward, which causes this to tighten up on the head. When they pull back here, this goes up, which causes this to tighten on the chin. So it's all mechanical. It's not a traditional hackamore. And this shows the squeezing action I'm talking about. When you start getting bits that squeeze, you get pressure here instead of with a traditional hackamore that's down here. When I pull back, this just slants forward a little bit. This slants back, and it helps the horse head go down and to the sides you want. I don't like squeezing actions here on anything. This, again, we're not getting the squeezing action. You've got a little bitty ring here that's hooked in the side. I don't like the metal. I don't like the snaps. I know it's fancy. I know it's easy. I know it's quick. But this, again, is giving the indication of the horse pulling to the side, which a lot of times will cause a horse to pull forward to resist this and you'll get somebody with high hands, or you end up pulling harder because the horse lifts his head, or you end up putting a tie down because you think the horse is lifting his head and the tie down will help, when all it does is brace the horse and it doesn't help you. Whereas if you're pulling here or here on a rope halter, you're pulling below the horse's chin, it goes straight back, it creates a little pressure downward, and it gives the left or right from underneath the chin, just like when you're leading a horse. It's more consistent, it's less newness to the horse, you don't have to change it when you get on a horse or get off a horse. This is some sort of side pull. When you pull on this, it tightens on the horse's chin, I guess leading a horse or making a horse follow. This is some mechanical, pretty, somebody wanted to make something blingy for somebody to buy, and oh, look at the pretty circles, and oh, it looks so pretty, and I want it. Well, this is a mechanical hackamore, or a mechanical bitless. When you pull back on this metal, it pulls this forward, which pulls this down and tighter. When this goes forward from pulling here, it pulls this downward, which tightens here and squeezes. When I pull back here, it pulls this upward, which squeezes underneath the chin. Again, all pressure around the nose instead of just guiding the horse that, hey, I want you to pull your head a little bit this way. It's confusing. I don't like it. It's not good for the horse. Again, more trinkets and flashy and blingy and snaps and hooks and buckles and oh, and again, this is pressure. When you pull on this bit here, it pulls pressure here. This rope tightens. So the horse feels the squeezing. You can see a little raw mark right there where they've been used. So the horse feels the squeezing, and that distracts him, whereas if you were just pulling from this rope halter here, he would feel a little pressure here. He would give to that pressure, and he would know which way to go. He gets one point of direction when the reins meet one point. When the reins meet two points, he gets squeezing and pressure and all kind of different pressures. It's just not as good. And then this one is where I had a traditional hackamore on Buddy. It's got the Feodor. This is a little Feodor that keeps the Bozell from moving back and forth. This is the hanger with no metal. This is the reins connected to the hackamore. This is a traditional hackamore. The furry thing you see hanging there is called a shoe fly. As he walks, it swings and it keeps the flies away from him. And then last but not least, on this one, oh, let me readjust. This is from my video where I teach you how to tie and connect. It says how to connect a horse lead rope to a halter for reins. And on this video, I show you how to tie this knot. And again, this is a rope halter. He gets his direction. Mr. T gets his direction at the same point as if I was walking him on the ground and leading him. Nothing changes. I'm just on his back. And when I pull to the left, he feels like if I was on the ground pulling to the left. And if I'm pull to the right, he feels as if we're on the ground walking and I pull to the right. It's consistent. It's less changing. I don't have to worry about leather rotting. I don't have to worry about changing. I don't have to worry about having 20 pieces of gear to clean. I don't have to worry about any metal around my horses. I like the rope halter. A lot of people will call this a rope hackamore. It doesn't have the metal piece that, or the leather that goes around the Bozell. Basically, your Bozell is a rope, and it's just called a rope hackamore. Know the difference. Know the difference between pain, leverage, squeezing, all the mechanics, chains, metal, not good for horses, snaps, not good. They break, they hit the horse, they bang, they get caught. That's why I like them. Hopefully I cleared all that up and everybody has a better understanding on this. And we'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.